Myself Padmaja, Associate Professor, Department of CSE, Institute of Aeronautic Engineering, Hyderabad. Now, today's topic is on lambda functions or anonymous functions in Python. Now, what is a lambda or anonymous function? These functions are so-called anonymous functions because they are not created or declared using the def keyword in Python, but they are created using the lambda keyword. Now, lambda functions are known as the throwaway functions because they are just needed whenever they are created and can be used wherever a function is required. Now, lambda functions mostly contain a single line, and before using the lambda function, let us first see what is the syntax of lambda function. Now, lambda arguments colon expression. So, lambda is the keyword. Arguments you can write comma separated list of arguments colon any arithmetic expression you can write based on your need. So the arguments here contains a comma separated list of arguments, and the expression is an arithmetic expression used in these arguments. Now the function, the lambda function, can be assigned to a variable to give it a name also. Now let us see some examples how to use this lambda functions. Now let us write one example to find the sum of two numbers using lambda function. So, first of all, we are writing the keyword lambda. For two numbers, we want to find out. So, we are taking two arguments here. So, lambda followed by x, y. These are known as the arguments. Lambda is the keyword. These are known as the arguments. Colon, this is an arithmetic expression we are writing. Here, x plus y is the arithmetic expression. So, the x plus y will be computed. And finally, the output of the function. The function is assigned to a variable. So, that is called sum is the variable name. So, x plus y, the sum variable, whenever you will pass two arguments to the lambda function, it will compute the x plus y, that is 5 plus 7, it will compute, and the result will be stored into the variable sum. So here the lambda x comma y colon x plus y, this is the way we should write a lambda function. So here x and y are known as arguments, and colon, this is the arithmetic expression or what you want to perform, what for this function has been created. We have written here to find the sum of two numbers. So x plus y is the arithmetic expression, and the whole function is assigned to a variable. So we can print the sum by writing like this. Sum is equal to sum of 5 comma 7. So 5 comma 7 are nothing but these are the arguments. And after passing the arguments, it will compute the sum and it will return the result. So this is the way we should write a lambda function. Now let us see one more example where the lambda function can be used with an ordinary function also. So how a lambda function you can write or use inside an user defined function. Let us see one example. Now, for example, we want to increment a variable's value. Suppose initially the variable A contains 100. Now, before increment, the value of the variable you are printing over here, so which is nothing but 100 will be printed. Now, we want to write our own user defined function to increment the value of the variable. So, increment is the name of the user defined function over here. So, increment is nothing but our user-defined function. So, to this user-defined function, we are passing an argument that is A. So, what is the value of A? The value of A is nothing but 100 we are passing. Okay. Now, let us see how the function works. So, we have defined this function using the def keyword. This is the keyword to define a user-defined function. So, def increment. Increment is the name of the function, and the value of y is 100 we are passing here. Now, in the return statement, we have written one lambda function. So, the purpose of this function is to increment the value of y. So, for incrementing, we have written one lambda function here in the return statement. So, in the return statement, lambda is the name of the function, argument is x. So, what it is doing? It is doing x plus 1. So, if x is 100, then it is doing x plus 1, which is nothing but 101. Okay. So, the lambda function can also be written along with the user-defined functions. So, it will return that expression to us. Now, you can see that the return statement, the increment function is assigned to a variable B. Okay, so B will contain the return value from the expression. So here our expression is the lambda function. So the lambda function returns 101, that is returned to B. So after the increment, we are printing the value of B. So you will get here 101. So here with this small example, you have to understand that a lambda function can be used in the return statement of a normal user-defined function also. Now let us see another example where a lambda function can be passed as an argument to a function. So how a lambda function can be passed as an argument to a function, let us see through this example. Now here we have defined two lambda functions to find out the square of a number and cube of a number. So we have defined here lambda, x is the argument, and what we want to do with that argument, we are finding out the expression is x into 2 and here x into 3. So these are the two lambda functions or anonymous functions we have defined, and these functions are defined or stored into the variable twice and thrice. So it will find out the twice of the number, it will find out the thrice of the number. So these two functions, these two lambda functions can be passed as an argument to a normal user defined function also. Let us see. So we have defined a user defined function. So to that function, we are passing the two arguments. The first argument is the lambda function. This is a lambda function, and here this is also a lambda function. And the second argument is nothing but a value that we are passing. So if you will pass like this, that means lambda function here can be passed as an argument to a ordinary function. So you can see here f is nothing but the lambda function what you have passed, and n is nothing but the value 4 which you are passing over here. And if you are printing the function or executing the function, it will find out for that value 4 into 2 it will do. And second time you are passing 3 as the value, so it will do 3 into 3 it will do. So you are getting the answers as 8 and 9. So in this manner, the lambda function can be passed as an argument to a function also. Now, let us see another example where we are using the lambda function to find the sum of first 10 natural numbers. So how to do it with the lambda function? Now, you can see here lambda is the keyword. So we have not used any argument over here. We are directly using the built-in sum function and built-in range function. So here lambda without any argument we have written, and in the expression part we are using the built-in function. So here sum and range both are built-in functions. So here the range of 1, 11, that means it will iterate for 10 times. So every time it will compute the sum. So if you will print this, you will get the output as 55. So because the question is to find out the sum of natural numbers up to 10. So it is 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 10. So this way lambda functions can also be used. Thank you so much. So in this video, we have learned how to make use of the anonymous function or lambda function for various purposes. So here we have seen a lambda function can be written with arguments and an expression to do some specific task. We have also seen how the lambda function can be used by writing in the return statement of a normal function, or a lambda function can be used as an parameter or argument to a normal function. And also we have written how to use the built-in functions along with the lambda functions. Thank you so much.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.